Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Planescape Torment Blind. Sorry. we're headed for the Great Foundry now. This might be something I just trapped. I'm just making sure. I don't know what. Oh, clot charm. No, I want that. It's a drop by the lady that Dekan did a mercy killing for.
All right.
Come on, my friends. Let's go into the Great Foundry.
Locked.
It's locked. You see a burly, bored-looking guard. State your business, please. Who are you? I am a guard of the Believers of the Source, sir. Believers of the Source? Yes, sir. Godsmen, we're called. Why? We are one of 15 recognized factions of Sigil, sir. We believe that every being has within it the spark of divinity, neither good nor evil, necessarily, but potential to be divine. Beyond divinity, we believe that there lies something greater. We believe all life has a purpose and a goal, and we are devoted to understanding what these goals are. We strive toward greatness with every step in our lives. Sounds important. We believe it is, sir. Can I help you with anything else? Yes, I had some more questions. State the nature of your requirement, sir. What are you doing? Guarding the gate, sir. Right, I had more questions. What is this place? You are in front of the Great Foundry, home to the Believers of the Source. What is the Great Foundry? Aside from being home to the Believers of the Source, it is also one of the largest foundries known to human existence. Much traffic passes through these gates. We take orders from all across the plains. Currently, we are not accepting any further orders, as most of our craftsmen are either working on a new project or are commissioned for the next several months on smaller orders. What this means in practical terms is that you're not getting in unless you have a receipt for work to pick up or have urgent business inside. I do have a receipt. Yes, sir. May I see your receipt? I guess I don't have one. I'm sure I had it on me. Yes, sir, I'm sure you did. However, until you can produce evidence that you have business here, I'm afraid we cannot offer admittance. I'm here to pick up an order. Alright. I'm here to put in an order. I'm sorry, sir, but we are currently we're not currently accepting any new orders due to a large project we have undertaken. Check back in about a year, sir. Thank you for your interest. should we lie? Sir, you do not appear to have a receipt. Alright, how the hell do we get in there? Beware, where it is that the Dustmen have freed something. I can tell him this, but not the other guy? Why? Just looking around. Then I'm certain you won't mind just passing along. May I come in? Not until you can demonstrate that you have business here, sir. Oh, now I can tell him. Hold on. I have a message from Keldor from Giltspur, the auctioneer. Thank you, sir. You'll find him in the Great Godsmen Hall. He opens the gate for you. Now, why does that disappear? And I don't know, maybe it was on the other guard, but if you don't choose it as your first option, it just disappears. Thanks. Alright. Whoa. Please keep the courtyard clear, either inside or outside. Alright, farewell.
I'm gone.
Still attacking me for a second. Welcome back, sir. You have no more business inside, I presume. Please keep the courtyard clear and keep moving. Those Doom Guard perks need to figure out that life isn't about crumbling away. It's not how long you live, but how you live that determines your next step towards enlightenment.
I'm gone. I'm gone.
Like sockets. Can't wait to get out of here. Foundry worker. You see a drab hiver hauling crates around. You can't even tell this poor sod sacks. What do you want from me? Just a couple of answers. Ask away. Who are you? Why? You with the Takers? I already paid my taxes. The Takers? Who? You know, the taxmen of the city. What are you, clueless? I have to get back to work. What do you want? Just some answers. Ask away. No, I was just curious, you know, being friendly. Don't really have time to be friendly, especially with the yard boss looking over the shoulder. We're busy these days. How about if I just tell you I can be friendly when this project's done? All right. Maybe you can answer another question. What are you doing? Making my daily wage. Working to improve myself. Keeping this place clean. Making sure the material gets to the smiths when they need it. Making sure the finished product gets wherever it's supposed to go. In short, my job. So your job is basically clean up and grunt work? If you want to look at it like that, since I'm learning this Godsman's creed, I figure it's a test of stubborns. I look at my whole life as a test of stubborns. Does that really help? Surprisingly, yes. Gives me hope that I'm going to end up better, either in this life or the next. I may be ignoring the obvious, but let me tell you that once you've eaten gutter swill like me, you get to appreciate the small kindnesses life throws your way. It ain't all primroses for the lower classes, Burke. The worker turns away. I gotta get back to work. Goodbye. Who's your boss? Why? You work for him? Are you kidding? One of the most rotten bastards that's ever been my misfortune to run across, and I grew up in the hive amidst some real winners, hoping it gets killed soon, painfully and horribly, but then most of us yard workers do. Got it. So long. Same thing. Godsmen. Yeah? What? Hurry it up, I'm busy here. Who are you? What I am is too busy to stand around gabbing with folks. You got a purpose here? Well, yes. Yeah, what? Hurry it up, I'm busy here. What do you do around here? Oh, I sit around with my feet up all day. Look, I don't mean to be rude, but it's fairly obvious what I'm doing here. I'm forging steelwork, and if I don't get back to it soon, I'll have to start over. Alright, I have a few more questions. What can you tell me about the Godsmen? The smith stops working and looks at you, as if measuring you. A Godsman is a basher who believes that we can all be gods, even you. Don't matter if it's for good or for ill, we all go through our existence learning how to evolve ourselves into even ever more perfect forms. Another definition of Godsman is learning is actually someone who starts to get peery of people who ask him questions they really should know the answers to. So what you're saying is that we've got tests to overcome and we become greater because of it? What I'm saying is that you should talk to one of the factotums through the door over in the east wall. They've got nothing better to do with their time. I have. Good day. I have a few more questions. Whoops. That didn't work. Where's your supervisor? You can usually find her down by the clerk's office, watching us. Hells, I guess it's her job, but I can be trusted to do mine. I'd imagine. Goodbye. See if this guy has anything else to say. Anything other than that to say. You step up to the forge. The heat is incredible. What do you do? Use the forge. The heat of the flame is too hot, even for your flame-toughened skin. You begin to take damage from the fire. Again, the flame sears your skin. What would you like to do first? I only have one option.
Done.
Alright, these guys all have the same Godsmen guard. You see a competent, somewhat bored-looking guard. Greetings, sir. May I be of assistance? What's behind those guarded doors? I'm afraid that's a secret, sir. Even from our valued faction members. Unless you're involved in the project itself, or unless you receive authorization from one of the high-ups, we can't allow you in. But I beat it out of you. Fine. Where can I find the high-ups? Either Sandoz or Keldor should be able to aid you in this matter. Keldor's in the main meeting hall, just through the door on the right side of the main foundry. Sandoz can usually be found in the rooms to the rear of the hall. Thanks. How do I find the clerk's office? Just south of the main foundry, sir, you'll find an office with a desk in it. That's the clerk's office. Thanks. Farewell. Alissa Tield. You see a short woman with slight horns in her forehead and ears that curve sharply back on her skull. She smells faintly of sulfur, even over the reek of the foundry's fires. Greetings, what can I do for you? Who are you? I'm Alissa Tild, supervisor for this area being the main foundry area of the Great Foundry. The main foundry area of the Great Foundry. Is that what I said? I don't know. Where much of our current public work takes place. The foundry is larger than this, of course, but we have a large contract we're working on, and we've been sworn to secrecy, so most of the work area is off-limits. My apologies. Off-limits? Ridiculous. Goodbye. I understand. I had some other questions. More questions? What are they? What's going on here? We've taken a huge and very, very secret contract, one that is taking up practically all our resources. We maintain a smaller operation for the day-to-day items for our other orders, but right now the foundry is devoted to fulfilling our contract. Don't bother asking about it, because I won't tell you. You seem very firm about this. Very well. I had other questions. What exactly do the Godsmen stand for? This is both a communal and individual faction, and there are variations on the theme depending on whom one speaks with, but the basic gist of it is that life, nay, all existence itself, is a test of sorts. All things that arise test us, and how we react determines how we move closer to the true understanding of everything. We seek the truth behind the multiverse, and it's apparent to us that ours is the right way. How do I join? Go speak to Keldor of Durian in the meeting hall, through the door on the right wall. Where could I get those items to work the forge? If you can't find them lying around somewhere, then you'll have to buy them from the clerk. For a nominal price, of course. I need to get into that guarded room back there. I'd love to help you, but only the real high-ups can authorize that. You'd have to speak to Keldor about that. I need to use the forge. Certainly. Just make sure you have the proper items for it. Protection from the flames, tongs, hammer, and of course your iron ore. Where would I get those items? See that? Same answer. I'm looking for the pickup office. I have an item waiting for me. It's that office with the desk. You should be sitting right behind it. I'd like a tour. Ordinarily, there's nothing I'd like better. Sadly, right now we're a little busy. Come back in a year or so, and I'll be happy to provide one. I've seen that already. Okay. Sarossa. So all the same answers. Oh, we can go up also.
If you keep bobbing about, Skull, I'm gonna mount you in the end of a pike.
He can't help himself. That's all he does is bob around and talk. You see a young woman. As you approach her, her eyes stare directly into yours. You get the uncomfortable feeling that she's not just examining your eye color. Her gaze seems to penetrate far deeper than that. Greetings, stranger. How goes your day? Well enough. I would like you to answer some questions for me. What answers do you seek, half-man? Why do you call me half-man?
Updated my journal.
I call you half-man because I cannot see your spirit. All other mortals who pass through my life show their spirits to me as a shining spark or smoldering ember. You show nothing at all. I call you half-man because I cannot see your spirit as I see those of others. Whether this is because you have no soul or because you have transcended, I cannot say. One way or another, you are but half a man. What the other half is, I cannot say. Who are you? I am Sarossa, daughter of Sandaz, one of the factors of the Godsmen. Tell me of your family. My brother Saros is a child of the Foundry, yet I fear he has never embraced the philosophy of the believers of the Source. My father is a factor here, and his travels have led him far from the Foundry and into realms most mortals never even dream of achieving. Tell me more about your brother. Saros is a brash, impulsive lad, easily given over to his manhood. He is eager to prove himself the equal of anything on the plains, full of the aggression of youth. I believe he feels himself more sensate than Godsmen, further vindicating my belief that the sensates are the most immature of all the factions of Sigil. Drink. Why are they the most immature? Why are they the most immature? Because, like children, they do not understand that there is more beyond the world of the senses, beyond what one can see, hear, taste, touch, smell. Look around you. You are in the outer planes. This is belief made solid, but that does not mean that seemingly rough matter can be comprehended by the senses. This is belief. No mere physicality can match it.
I don't trust the Gith. I say we leave him behind.
Also gotta see what's upstairs.
Right.
Foundry Smith. He gives you a quick glare and refocuses his attention on the speaker. Shh! I'm trying to listen to Keldor. I want to learn, and you're interrupting me.
Done. I'm gone.
Same. There's Saros.
Done.
Guys are all the same. Yeah, I talked to him already. Talk to Saros. You see a sandy-haired youth. He's on the cusp between adolescence and adulthood, and from his eyes, it looks like he's trying to be as adult as possible without having the slightest idea how. In other words, he seems innocent. Hey, stranger, what can I do for you? You can answer a few questions for me. Ask whatever you want. Tell me about yourself. Me? I'm Saros. I grew up around here. Got to run through the foundry, playing with stuff. I like pretty much everyone here, except for Thildon. He keeps saying I'm not raised right, and that my father is a poor parent. All I know is that Thildon's the biggest sod I've ever met. I'm sure. Tell me about the Great Foundry. I grew up here. I played in the main foundry area and ran through the barracks. It stinks, and it's loud, and people can be like Thildon, but it's still home to me. Tell me about the people here. They're smiths and workers. I think they mean well, but they're all so earnest and boring. They need to liven themselves up a bit, like, say, the sensates. You like the sensates, huh? They know how to live life. They know what it's all about. Not like these people. They keep pretending there's some big noble purpose to it all, but I don't see it. My sister says that life is more than our senses show, but I don't see how she knows that, since all she knows is through her senses. I just don't get why people make this stuff up. Who's your sister? Sarossa? She can just look at someone and see what needs adding and what needs taken away. I don't know how she does it. My father always said it was something about her ascending to another level. He said she was a born godsman. Thanks. Farewell. Alright, guess we're talking to Keldor, so the spark of divinity is within us all. You see a sturdy man who looks like he's just bursting with vitality. His face is tanned and lined, and his black beard is beginning to show hints of white. Hail, stranger, and well met. What can I do for you this fine day? Let's ask him questions first. I'd like to ask you a few questions. What do you want to know? Who are you? He smiles broadly. My friend, I'm Keldor of Durian, one of the factotums of the Godsmen, an anomaly in charge of this place while our true high-ups have gone in conclave. What can you tell me about this place? This is the Great Foundry, home of the Believers of the Source, also known as the Godsmen. Here we make items that ship all over the plains. We are renowned in many worlds. Only the best work here. It's said that we've got a staff of smiths that rival those in Mount Clangeddon itself. Personally, I don't think we're that good, but we are close. Can you take on additional work? Sadly, friend, we cannot. We've engaged in a long-term contract right now that's taking up most of our resources. Perhaps when we're finished, in a matter of years, he shrugs. My apologies. What can you tell me of the people here? We've got a wide range of folks here, most of whom are the smiths and the workers who keep this place running. We've also got a pair of engineers who are doing some incredible things with the fabric of reality. Ask Nihl Xander about his Dreambuilder someday. Yeah, maybe I will. I'm not sure if I want to join them. I'll make that decision carefully. I'd like to see the secret project if I could. He smiles. Friend, I can't give that to you until you prove yourself a friend of the Godsmen. I have a message for you from Giltspur, the auctioneer. A message, eh? He takes a note from you. Very well. You can tell him the message is delivered. Was there anything else you wanted? Nothing, thanks. Farewell. Oh, there's Nihl Xander, about his Dreamweaver project. He's also upstairs from there. You see a bushy-haired man, clad in the height of fashion, if you consider fashion to have died 50 years ago. His clothing seems to consist of tattered street urchin rags, and he seems to affect a disdainful manner toward those around him, or that might be his actual manner. He doesn't even glance at you until you speak to him, and then his eyes begin searching your face carefully. Do you want something? He drawls. Who are you? I am Nihl Xander, great-grandson of the Artificer Zero Xander, engineer, dreamer, creator. And I have finished his work, the work that you commissioned, the Dreambuilder. Are you ready to claim the use of it now? A Dreambuilder? What's that? I commissioned? It is both machine and ritual. It is a state of mind and a construct of steam and blood. It grants dreams to those who enter its confines. It was built for you, and it's waiting for you. Are you ready to finish it off? It's been waiting for you for decades. How do you know it was built for me? Because my great-grandfather, Zero Xander, set your face in stone so that we would know you and return to work for the work you commissioned. He always thought you'd return, but... No one else truly believed you would. Our family completed it because he said we would. And now, here you are. Do you still have this stone? No. It was stolen from me a year ago. I saw only a shadow flitting away. It was the only item taken from my home. I have no idea who'd take it, but I'd memorized the features. Oh, that's interesting, but let me ask him some questions first. A small frown on concentration creases his already wrinkled forehead. What would you like to know? What can you tell me about the Godsmen? He sighs and collects himself. That's a long subject. Let's get started on it. Now, creatures want something, don't they? They create, they build, they tear down, they dream, they fight, they fornicate. They do all these things because they want something beyond what they have. Even on the basis level of existence, every iota strives to be something greater. Some achieve this. Some fall by the wayside. Go on. Every decision, every action, every reaction, these all create a base on which something else builds. Seems obvious, then, that our current exalted state of being is building a base for ourselves for something greater. What is that, if not godhood? That's the way I've always justified it, and frankly, I ain't in the mood for philosophical discussion. You want that? Find a factor or something. Where can I find a factor? Factor Keldor is right up there on the dais. Talk to him, or else find that suicidal Burke Sandoz and talk to him. Are you done pestering me yet? Not yet. Tell me about your co-workers. Bah! They do not possess a true fire. They speak of creation, and they boast of their potentials, but they do not create anything beyond the mundane. Their imaginations are poor, limited, obsessed with the small details. A true dreamer, I say, creates a grand scheme and then concentrates on the details. Starting with details is for the ants of the imagination, the small insects who aspire only to be fed. What do you do here? What do I do? I'm the engineer of all engineers. I studied under the Teneri Smith Kazan, who tempered words on a forge of hate, quenched them in a trough of despair, and sent them forth to slaughter stupidity. Elements of phrases, I'm getting tired, guys. Caustic words were brought to him, and he created weapons of terrifying magnitudes, weapons that would lay an enemy low and destroy the malformed ideas of others. I'm sure you've seen his work. So you create evil weapons here? Not at all. My forge is not built on hate, but on understanding. I have also studied under the Archon artisan Terasaphorea, who created the healing touch of a gentle thought, ideas that would still any fiendish spitting heart. He worked his will with love and devotion. My work blends theirs, as all mortal psyches blend elements of the demonic and the sublime. Are your co-workers as well trained as you? Alright, same answer as that. You mentioned a Dreambuilder before. Tell me about that now. Alright, let's finish the Dreambuilder. What I need to begin the final stages of the Dreambuilder is a piece of your skin immersed in your blood, so the machine can familiarize itself with your physical essence. It must be in a blue-green bottle to symbolize the dream sea on which you will float. I don't know that I want to fetch that for you. You don't, eh? Then maybe you ought to remember that you're fetching these items for a design you funded for a project you wanted created in the first place, for a device so impractical that the solution to it consumed the lives of 4 generations of my family, all for you. If you want to see this project complete, you'll finish the final stages and stop your endless whining. Fine, all right, I'll do it. Just stop yelling at me. All right. It's up here. Godsmen guard. Sorry, no one's allowed up here until the Factor Sandoz gets back. You can't come in. What can you tell me about him? He's a believer, sir. A true believer. But he's moody, and all that travel across the multiverse can't be good for your head. You either lose perspective or get too much of it. Either way, it ain't good. I'm hoping he'll make it back safe. We'll see, I suppose. Farewell. Well, I'm in here. I thought I wasn't allowed in here. Sandoz seemed very preoccupied. I wonder what he's worried about. He's been in there for a long time.
All right.
Locked.
All right, it's there that I can't go in.
I'm gone. All right.
Yes. Yeah.
I'm gone.
Okay. Tune back next time when we speak to Badai Lin and check these doors. See what's inside. Thanks for watching as always. See you next time and a bang bang boogie and don't stop the boogie.